In the previous step, we had created our destination. Now we will go to SAP Web IDE and create our Fiori application. To do that, click on Services. Here, search for Web IDE. Click on it. Click on Go to Service. This will open the Web IDE. Now we are inside the SAP Web IDE. So let's create our first application using the Cloud Connector. To do that, right click on Workspace, select New. I will select Project from Template. And here I will use pre-built application type, Fiori Worklist application. In this type of application, I want to show the list of training courses because I have created my service in such a way that it will show a list of all the training courses. Let me show you. So here you can see the name of the service is 000SRV and this is my entity. And this entity is returning me training ID, description, duration, and who created this entry and when this entry was created. So in this way, I have three records. This is the second record. And if I scroll down, this is the third record. So I have three entries. I want to show these three entries in my Fiori app over here. So now I will select Fiori Worklist and I will click on Next. Here I will write the name of the project. I will select C, Training Details, Title. I will write Training Course Details. The namespace I will write training.namespace. I will click on Next. And here I need to select my data source. In the previous step, we had created our destination. So the destination should appear over here. So let's click on this drop down and check. Wow, we have our destination available. So let's select it. Now it is trying to connect the destination through the Cloud Connector. So here you can see that I can access all the services that are inside my on-premise system. So let me find this service. My service name is ZGW_training000SRV. So here I will search for my service 000. So now I have my service. I will select this service. And now it is showing me that service is selected. Now I will click on Next button. And here I will map the elements of this application with my OData service. So I will close it. Here I will select what type of my application is. So here I can select whether my application will be deployed on Fiori Launchpad or is this just a standalone application. So I will select standalone application, object collection. Here I can select which type of entity I want to bind. So here you can see that I want to bind my ZCDS train course entity type because I have all my details inside this entity. So I will select train course. So train course is selected and in the object collection ID, I need to select the record which uniquely identifies it. Training ID is uniquely identifying my record. Object title. Object title will be shown in the first column. So in the first column, I want to show the description of the training. And in the object numeric attribute will be shown in the second column. So I will select the duration over here. Actually, it has by default picked it up because it is a numeric entity. And here on place of unit of measure, I do not have any unit of measure as of now for my record. So I will click on Next button. And now I will click on Finish. Now it is creating my application. Now our application is generated. Let's run it and see if it works. I will run it as a web application. Now it is loading. And here is my app. You can see that all the data from the on-premise system has been fetched inside our SAP UI5 application. I have just taken the example of SAP UI5 application using the cloud connector, but you can create many other types of application, not limited to SAP UI5. You can use cloud connector in n number of ways. There are so many features available inside cloud connector, whether it is security, authentication, data from SAP system or non-SAP system. Please try to practice this scenario inside your own trial account. And if you face any type of issue, feel free to contact me.